Fascinating discovery has been made in Canada. The remains of 215 children have been found buried at the site of a former boarding school, part of a nationwide scheme that took in First Nations children in an effort to assimilate them into Canadian society.
After being forcibly separated from their parents, children were made to convert to Christianity and banned from speaking their native languages.
This up, what they would do is they would give us other religions, other customs, and so on and so forth to disrupt our minds such that we would hate one another, hate our even our own children. You can come over here, don't go over there, to disrupt our minds, like even this, disrupting us. But what we're doing is we're gathering ourselves back together under our customs, other our culture.
Right.
Read that, Genesis 49.
Genesis chapter 49 and verse 1. Uh-huh. And Jacob called unto his sons.
So our forefather, Jacob, also known as Israel, called, gathered all of his family together. You have a large family or a small family? You don't really know your family. Okay, all right. That's unfortunate. But hey, that's an indicator to show that you are an Israelite.
Right.
But so, yeah.
Sis. I know it may not look like it, right? You say you don't really know your family. All of us that you see here, we didn't know each other. You know what brought us together? God's word.
That's right.
What I'm saying? Because if you take a look back right here, you see here, sis? This is your family.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? This is your family. The things that happen to your people is the same thing that happened to our people. It's prophesied in the scriptures. You're not native, so-called native Indians. Guess what? You're an Israelite. From the tribe of Gad.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But when they came and they conquered us and they gave us religion, they gave us different names, they gave us different languages, they separated us. You understand what I'm saying? So that when you, for example, you look at the so-called Haitians, they look at the so-called American blacks and they think they're different. But when you look at their history, it's the same thing that happened to them. You look at the so-called Native Indians, I appreciate you taking the time to, you know, come in to see what we're about. But sometimes our native, so-called native brothers and sisters, they look at us like, you know what I'm saying, like ignorers, you know what I'm saying? Like they don't like blacks, you know what I'm saying? Because they don't understand that we're the same people. That's true. People are afraid of what they don't understand. You understand? So even though you said you don't have a lot of family, what I'm trying to let you know is we have the largest family all over the earth.
That's right.
This is all your family.
Right.
According to the Bible. Because I know also sometimes so-called First Nations, when they hear the Bible, they don't really like the Bible. You know why they don't like the Bible? Go back to Psalms 55, which you were reading earlier. No, keep that up. I want to show you something real quick. History, Bible history. Read that real quick.
Psalm chapter 55 and verse 21.
I'm going to show you. I understand why so-called First Nations may be turned off sometimes by the Bible. You understand what I'm saying? But what you need to understand is the Bible the issue, or is the people that came and said that they were the people of God the issue? Because if you say that you represent God, there's certain things that needs to follow in terms of your actions. But let's see what they did. Watch this.
Verse 21. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter. But what?
Start at verse 20.
Verse 20. He hath put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him. He hath broken his covenant.
Let me ask you something. How many covenant and peace treaties when the so-called Caucasians came here? How many did they do with the so-called Native Indians? They did a lot. They did a lot of covenant, a lot of peace treaties. You understand?
Right.
Like, for example, You see this image right here? When they arrived here, the so-called conquistadors, they came to South America, Central America, North America. This is your people. Your people were being peaceful with them. Your people greeted them with gifts.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? But watch what happened.
Verse 20. He had put forth his hand against such as be at peace with him.
Stop.
No, we have something
we
want to say.
Initially, yeah. Don't worry. I'll give you a second. I know you guys are used to whenever you come and, you know, the whole world stops.
I'm 18.
You understand what I'm saying? Hold on. I know you say you got a question or you got a comment. Don't worry. We got you. We got you. Just be patient. All right? Be patient with us.
Yep.
Read again.
He had put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him.
So, again, you guys were at peace with them. You understand what I'm saying? But it said that they put forth their hands against such as were at peace, because eventually, did that peace sustain? Did it stay peace? No. This is what they did. Enslaved y'all. Murdered y'all. Raped y'all. Genocide. You understand? Indoctrinated y'all.
Right.
Read on.
He had broken his covenant.
They have broken all the peace treaties that they've made with the so-called First Nations. You understand what I'm saying? Read on.
The words of his mouth were smoother than butter.
Read that again.
The words of his mouth were smoother than butter.
What were the words of his mouth that were smoother than butter? God loves you. God is peace. Jesus Christ put it in our heart to come and give us the gospel. And when they said Jesus Christ, this is who they meant.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? This is the image that they taught us was Jesus Christ. But Jesus Christ never looked like that in the Bible. You understand what I'm saying? This is the symbol of white supremacy. When they pushed that image on the so-called First Nations, it was to make you think, to enslave your mind, to make you think that they're God. You understand? So that you would never have a thought to rebel against them. You see what I'm saying? Read again.
The words of his mouth were smoother than butter, but war when it was in his heart.
But what?
The war was in his heart.
So you see that? They came appearing as though they came for peace. They came appearing as though they're here to evangelize and teach you about God.
Right.
And teach you about Jesus.
Right.
But what was in his heart?
The war was in his heart.
Again, you guys were a peaceful people.
Right.
When they came here, bearing them gifts. But eventually, what did they do? Enslaved y'all.
Bring it out.
Murdered y'all.
Right.
Hanged y'all.
Right.
Indoctrinated
right.
y'all.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? To the point to this day that a lot of so-called First Nations, they don't want to hear nothing about the Bible. Why? Because they remember that history. You see what I'm saying? They remember that history. Read that again. They are the so-called First Nation because they are the children of Israel from the tribe of Gad. You understand? That's why I say so-called. You are the Israelites from the tribe of Gad. Keep reading.
It's not so-called. His words were softened and ordered. Yes, were they strong for?
See that? Yeah, what they want? Brother, but come and find out why I'm saying so-called. You're an Israelite from the tribe of Gad. That's why I'm saying so-called, brother. That's why I'm saying so-called. Okay, watch this, watch this. Come and find out why I'm saying so-called. Okay, brother.
Okay, brother, I'm
heart?
A Nahio from here. Watch I'm it. Not an Israelite.
Drawn swords. Yes, sir, you
I
are.
I was born here.
Yes, sir, you are. You see that?
No,
drawn
no,
swords.
You're brown.
We're in the
you're
heart of the
Africa.
So-called Caucasians, the so-called
your history
Europeans.
Is over right. there.
You understand
don't
what
come
I'm
and show history.
Read that again.
Hey,
the word of his
you
mouth
can't show us our history. From here,
brother, we're here
not
for you. We're here for you. We're here to teach you your history.
You're not
you understand
from
what I'm
here.
Saying? You're my brother.
You can't
but guess what? Whether
history.
You like it or not, brother, this gospel is going to go out.
That's
you
right.
can't stop this. You understand what I'm saying? Your arms are too short to box with God.
Right. right.
Read on.
But war was in his heart. His words were softened in oil, yet were they drawn swords.
See that? Drawn swords. What are we reading? This is Bible history. But what are we doing? We're linking Bible history to so-called First Nations history. You understand what I'm saying? So that's why I want you, when you leave here, to know that your history is in the Bible.
Right.
That's why when the brother was bringing up earlier. You see this here right here? The so-called fringes, when you see, you know, go to pawpaws and, you know, they wear the things. That's actually in the Bible. Have you ever read that? Have you ever heard that? Let's read it. Numbers. Because the reason why we have it, remember he was talking about, you said culture appropriation. Again, y'all may look at us and say, well, why are you guys wearing this at the bottom of your clothes? This is culture appropriation. No, it's not. It is culture appropriation in the sense of we're realizing who we are, and now we're trying to come back and let you know who you are.
Right.
You understand? That's the reason why we came out here. And they don't want us here.
Right.
They were trying to set up a festival over there, and they didn't want us. You know why they didn't want us? Because they knew that if we coming out here to let you know, teach you the scriptures according to who you are, is going to disrupt their pockets.
Right. You know?
And all praise to the Most High. Guess what they did? They packed up and left. We were set up over there, they kicked us out. We were set up across the street, they kicked us out. And we came over here. Guess what? We're very persistent for our people.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? We're very persistent for our people. Just like they were persistent in trying to destroy us, guess what? We have to be 10 times more persistent in trying to rebuild our people back up. You see what I'm saying?
Ready?
Read this.
Numbers 15 and verse 38.
This is the reason why we wear what we wear at the bottom. Go ahead.
Speak unto the children of Israel. And
speak unto who?
The children of Israel.
This is, what's your name? K, from the beginning of the book to the end of the book, this is only talking about the children of Israel.
That's right.
They've taken this book and they've made it a universal book where now everyone thinks that everybody, this is for everybody. It's not. It says for who? Read again.
Speak unto the children of Israel.
K, you are a child. You are a daughter of Israel.
That's right.
From the tribe of Gad.
Right.
Read on.
And bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments.
Fringes on what?
In the borders of their garments.
See that? Fringes on the borders of their garments. Garment means clothing. Fringes on the borders of their clothing. Watch this.
In the borders of their garments throughout their generations.
Meaning forever. Go ahead.
And that they put upon the fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue.
A what?
A ribbon of blue.
So the same way you see, we have the fringe, and then we have the ribbon of blue. You see what I'm saying? The same way back then, they also had the same thing. You know what I'm saying? They had the fringes, and they had the border of blue. Read on.
And it shall be unto you for a fringe, that ye may look upon it, and remember all the commandments of the Lord.
And what?
And remember all the commandments of the Lord.
Because understanding that we are the children of Israel, what comes with that is that God gave us commandments.
Right.
You understand? Commandments that he did not give to anybody else. You see what I'm saying? So that was the meaning, the spiritual meaning behind the fringes. It was to remember that we have to keep God's commandments. You see what I'm saying? Now let me ask you a question. Do you know how your forefathers and foremothers came to this side of the world? You don't know? Because if I say that we're, what? If I say that according to the Bible, you're the children of Israel. Well, when you think of Israel, you think of the land of Israel, right? So you might say, well, how are we the children of Israel, but we are here in Canada, or we are here in North America? See what I'm saying? That's a history behind us. Can I show it to you? Watch this, 2 Esdras, chapter 13.
The book of 2 Esdras, chapter 13, and verse 40. Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king.
So it says those are the 10 tribes that were carried away prisoners. I want you to see something right here, okay? So you see the tribes right here? When you read in the New Testament and you read about the Jews, this is who it's talking about, the Jews in the New Testament. Judah, Benjamin, and Levi. You understand? In the time of Christ. When the Romans came and conquered them, they fled into Africa. By that time, see the rest of the tribes? Ephraim, Manasseh. For example, the so-called Puerto Ricans, who are so-called Latinos, their ancestors is who? Native, so-called Native Indians. They intermingle with Caucasian, and now they have like Latino background or Latin background where they speak Spanish. You see what I'm saying? But their ancestors were Taino Indians, so on and so forth. You see what I'm saying? So all these tribes on down, Ephraim, Manasseh, the so-called Cubans, Dominicans, Guatemalans, Panamaeans. See that? That was the Mayans. So-called American Indians. On down, those are the 10 tribes. You see what I'm saying? Now, before, what happened? They went into captivity. They went into slavery. Now, watch this. Read again.
Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land. The time of Hosea the king, whom Salmaneser the king of Assyria led away captive, and he carried them over the waters, and so came they into another land.
Read on.
But they took this counsel among themselves.
So after they were freed, right, they were in captivity under the Assyrians in the Bible. After they were freed, what your guys did, the so-called First Nation, Ephraim on down, what y'all did is y'all took a council among yourselves. You understand what I'm saying? Read on.
But they took this counsel among themselves, that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go forth into a further country where never mankind dwelt.
So y'all came here. That's why you call First Nations here, because you guys were the first to come here. You understand? On this side of the world, the so-called Western Hemisphere. You understand? South America, Central America, North America. You guys were the first ones to establish here. That's why you guys are the First Nations. No one lived here before you guys.
Right.
You guys took that counsel and said, we're going to go into a further country because Israel is on the Eastern Hemisphere.
Right.
You guys came all the way to the Western Hemisphere.
Bring it up.
You understand what I'm saying? Let me see here. You see, Israel is more on that side. Huh? Cairo, yeah, around here. See what I'm saying? So you guys, it was a long journey for you guys to come all the way around to come to the Americas. You see what I'm saying? And it's going to tell you that. Read on.
Verse 42. That they might there keep their statutes, which they never kept in their own land. And they entered into the Euphrates.
The Euphrates River. Go ahead.
By the narrow passages.
That's the narrow passage. You see what I'm saying? The narrow passage to go around. Because you guys were in that area. You have to go around to that small, narrow passage to go all the way around. Go ahead.
Of the river, for the Most High then showed signs for them and held still the flood.
Because those are rough waters. You understand what I'm saying? We're talking about millions of you guys that came around. You understand what I'm saying? Through rough waters. The only way you guys were able to do that is because the Great Spirit, as you guys call it, which is Yahweh, the Most High God, held still the water. You understand what I'm saying? For you guys to go through. Well, to fulfill prophecy. Go ahead.
Right.
Till they were passed over.
Go ahead.
For through that country, there was a great way to go.
Go ahead.
Namely, of a year and a half.
See that? It took a year and a half. So let me ask you something. That sounds like a map to me. You understand what I'm saying? If I want to know where a certain people is and how long it takes for me to get there, that sounds like a map in order for me to know how to get there. You agree? Watch this.
And the same region is called Arceret.
So that region of North America, Central America, South America, what did the Bible call it?
And that region is called Arceret.
So according to the Bible, it's called Arceret. You understand? It's called Arceret. Now watch this. Remember I said that sounds like a map. It tells you how to get there, and it tells you how long it takes to get there. Guess who read that map? Let's see.
Arceret, the name of the land beyond the great river.
Beyond the great river Euphrates. Go ahead.
Beyond the great river, far away from the habitation of man.
Far away from the eastern hemisphere. Go ahead.
In which the 10 tribes of Israel will dwell, observing the law of Moses until the time of restoration, according to Second Ezra, chapter 13, verse 45. Columbus identified...
Who?
Columbus.
Y'all familiar with Christopher Columbus? The first Caucasian that came to what they call the New World. You understand what I'm saying? Read that again.
Columbus identified America with...
Columbus identified America, meaning what? North America, South America, Central America. Go ahead.
Columbus identified America with this land.
With this land. Which land? What we were just reading. The land of Arceret. That's how he figured out there's more to just the Eastern Hemisphere.
Right.
There are some people here. There are the 10 tribes of Israel are here on this side of the world.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying? This is that was his roadmap in order for him to come and find you guys. You see what I'm saying? So what are we reading? This is your history.
Thank you. We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.